Hello everyone, this is Niuniu. Welcome to CRI Learn Chinese Facebook page, YouTube channel, and 英语环球广播微博. Welcome to the second season of Old Wisdom, New Insights. Today is some day very special here in China because today is the Duanwu Festival or Dragon Boat Festival, probably as you know. So I'm gonna say have a happy Duanwu, 端午节快乐. Have a healthy and safe Duanwu, 端午安康. First and foremost, let's see who's with us today. I see many of you already tuning in, saying hello. I'm saying hi to Harry, to Shanking, as well as Shanking saying 祝大家端午节快乐，愿大家端午安康. That's very nice of you. Thank you. And I have a friend saying 早上好，老师, wearing a blue shirt, wearing sunglasses in your profile photo, because I don't know your language and sorry, I do not know how to pronounce it, but very happy to have you here with our live stream. 玉立一众 saying 早安，早安 to you too. And I also see Gison saying beautiful. Jesse is here. Ray is also here saying dragon boat. Shahid saying amazing. Yes, because today is the Dragon Boat Festival or Duanwu Festival here in China. It falls on the fifth day of the fifth lunar month on China's lunar calendar. And on this day, it suggests that the summer is stepping in gradually, and with summer coming here, all the insects and little animals are arriving, or let's say waking up from the ground. So 端午节, there are many different traditions. Some traditions have something to do with this, that is with the waking up of all these insects. You have to wear some perfume pouch, you have to wear the kind of herbs that would give out all these nice fragrance so that you keep the insects away from you. And another very important tradition of Duanwu Festival would be have something to do with Qu Yuan, the poetic, very romantic, patriotic scholar living in the Warring States period, living in the ancient state of Chu. We say 战国时期的楚国诗人屈原. 战国时代 would be the Warring States period. 楚国, the ancient state of Chu. 诗人, a poet. There is a lot, well actually I think there are different Duanwu traditions having something or having relations with Qu Yuan, and we are going to talk a little bit about them in today's live stream. As for my location right now I am in Zigui County, Hubei province, and this is the birthplace of Qu Yuan. Besides all the Qu Yuan related traditions, this place is also the hometown of many intangible cultural heritage here in China. And during this traditional Chinese holiday, Duanwu Festival, we get to experience all these different kinds of intangible cultural heritage, handicrafts and items. So let's step into this 非遗小巷. 非遗, 非物质文化遗产. 非 means no, 物质 means material, 文化, culture, 遗产, heritage. So, intangible cultural heritage, 非物质文化遗产, having that in mind, we can go inside and I could get to see what are some fun items in this intangible cultural heritage lane, 非遗小巷, 我们往里走一走啦。 In the meantime, I see Rital saying, 祝你端午节快乐, happy to you too, very happy to see you, very glad to have you in today's live stream. And in the meantime, you can see that this lane is not that long, it's not a really long lane, but actually it contains a lot of different items, a lot of different, different things we get to watch. For example, I get to see this here, so what is this? Let's have a look. 您在做什么呀?
艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾条，艾
Salamis, 艾草. And for this 艾草, this wood, wormwood or mugwort, you smash them into this tiny little pieces, and then this lovely lady here is going to wrap them in this piece of paper. 能做一下, 我们看看吗?
可以的。
哦, 这么多吗?
对,这个艾绒。艾绒? 对,艾绒,把它放在这里面。
So you stick it in, make sure they are firm and solid, 把它压实啊, 是要压实。
对,压实。
And wrap it with this piece of paper. Okay, you wrap it with, and then you add another piece of paper. Stick them together. 这是水吗? 胶啊, 好嘞。 With some glue. 胶, 糯米胶, 糯米胶. So it's actually made of sticky rice. So it's sticky rice glue. Glutinous goo.
对,
Hey, that's how you get one of this. 这就是一个艾条了. So as you can see with the herb inside of it, for traditional Chinese medicine, they would light up this side and have the scent. I think roaring around you and having this heat getting a little bit inside your body, transmit the energy and the healing power of 艾条. 谢谢您,谢谢,很有趣哦. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment area, because I myself is only learning all these fun, intangible cultural heritage, 非物质文化遗产. And of course, there are traditional Chinese medicine, there are beautiful clothing, and there are art craft. So right here, I see 霞江草编, 草 would be grass, and 边 would be weaving or plaiting. So these are actually straw plaiting. Check them out. They are really delicate and very vivid. Wow. 这是羊,对不对? 山羊, this is a goat. 山羊, 草边的山羊。 这是什么? 这鹿吗? 鹿, deer. 梅花鹿, deer. And this is a dragon. 麒麟, okay, it's not exactly a dragon, it's a dragon-shaped, mysterious monster in traditional Chinese fork tale. And of course, we've got our 龙舟 and our 粽子. So 龙舟, do you remember, did you watch the live stream yesterday? We went on the dragon boat, 龙舟, the dragon boat. I myself had my first dragon boat experience. 我也进行了龙舟初体验,我是划过龙舟的人了。 So this dragon boat is also very vivid. You get to see the dragon head in the beginning of it, and also the dragon tail at the end of it. And if you put some tiny little zongzi, the stickerized dumpling on it, it's even more beautiful. I think it's very interesting. I see some comments from you guys here. We have got Win saying, thank you for sharing your insights into the history of the festival. Thank you very much for sharing that message. That's very nice of you. And also we have Godwin saying, wonderful tradition, wonderful, 非常棒的文化传统. Thank you very much. And important lesson to learn, Roger saying, good morning, enjoy as much as you can. Good to know about local heritage and handicrafts, we'll share. Thank you. If you guys like the live stream, please like and share and comment as much as possible. It helps us a lot and it helps fellow Chinese lovers to find us. And as you can see, 草边 is the item or the theme of this room. And also this is the stop we have here in the intangible cultural heritage lane, 非遗小巷，屈原故乡的非遗小巷。See, the straw plating can not only be very beautiful, but also practical. 我可以看一下那个包包吗？ May I see this bag? Okay, see, I'm wearing blue, so I'm going to take the blue one. You take the blue one, these are all straw. And you dial it, 染色. Then...This is your bag. See, I can have a bag. Does it work for me? Is it good? I think it's a pretty, pretty bag. So, yes, it can be very practical. Very practical. Can hold many things. 可以装很多东西啊，这个包包。把它放回来。Environmentally friendly, practical, and also beautiful and interesting. 所以您是老板是吗？Ah, so we found the shop owner of this place, and let me ask if I can learn a little bit about straw plating. 那我可以学一点草编吗？
可以啊。
Ah, okay, so it's my turn to learn a little bit about it. See, let's see what he's doing here. 您现在这个在做的是？
这个是做的一个，这个。
哦、oh, ，小粽子是吗？粽子会不会太难了？对我来说，我要不要做一个简单的？
可以。
Okay, so I'm gonna learn something simple.
下面一片叶子就挑起来，下面我们把下面的叶子挑起来。好，你来做一下。
OK， 我来做一下。OK， so in order to make something，
要挑下面的叶子。
好 ，in order to make something like this。The straw plaiting or straw weaving, I think it's like weaving. You see all these latitude and longitude lines are put together. So what I'm doing is also putting them together, sticking them together in a way that they can be fixed with themselves. 把下面的挑起来，然后把叶子放进去是吗？
对，放进去。
See, I am taking those...啊，可以
哎！翻个面
哦，翻个面。
嗯，对，颜色。
哦，颜色不一样。
嗯，对。
哦 ，OK， so 颜色 would be color. They're in different colors. So if you take a closer look, you can see that both sides of this straw of this 艾草，艾草是艾草吗？
粽叶，
粽叶，对，说对，不应该是艾草。粽叶 ，so the leaf of the sticky rice dumpling is a special kind of plant, and you can see that both sides are.With different colors, so in order to make the zongzi, the sticky rice dumpling-shaped straw plaiting or artifact beautiful, you need to make sure the color is matching. So find the correct color. The light one is supposed to be up. So I am getting the ones already there. Okay, so these three ones.然后把它放进去是吗？
嗯，对的。
哦，这个要做多，就是要
才是一个面儿还没
才是一个面儿是吗、
嗯？
那我可以做一个立刻就可以做好的那个简单的吗？那个要比较久啊。
那都是别要时
对啊，都比较久啊。好，那我们来做一个面吧。
嗯、
so let's make a little bit of this. While I'm doing that, perhaps I think I can talk to you guys a little bit as well. I'm saying hello to Giovanni, to Kenny M. Kenny, you're here. Very happy to see you here. You're saying Niuniu and the crew had some 粽子. Yes, we had some 粽子 yesterday. 我们昨天吃粽子了。我们昨天吃了粽子，也是这里的编的粽子啊。一会儿可能可以看到。So a bit later, perhaps we get to see the 粽子 here in the intangible cultural heritage line. And right now, what I'm doing is 草编 in local, it's a local intangible cultural heritage item. 这是一个草编是一个 非遗项目啊，草编。要编几行啊？
六片叶子啊，这样。
六哦，已经六了是吗？
六片叶子之后，这个不要拿走。
不要拿走。
嗯。
So I cannot move it. Oh, I have to make them tight and
stick together.
调整好之后，把这个放这边来。
哦。
要把这个叶子调整。
Okay.So what I'm doing here is to make sure all the tiny straws are together and are
close to each other. Oh. I'm not really sure if I'm doing it. I don't think I'm doing it. I think he's only showing me.啊，我懂了，就是一上一下。Okay, so if you take a closer look, you get to see that all these straws need to be put exactly together, one up, one down. So you put one press on the other ones, and another one would be put under, under. You put it like that, and under. 这样，这样哈。
嗯，好，这边呢，又有一点区别了。
哦。
这个，要把这个剪掉。
哦，已经剪掉了。
对，这一点剪掉，这一点剪掉之后，把这个移开。啊，这个。
这个是压上去的，然后下一个在下面是吗？
嗯，这个是顺着这边。
哦，是顺着的。
嗯。这样，那下一片叶子。
我觉得这样，您来编，我来看一下。
嗯、
我觉得这一段比较复杂。I think this part is a little bit complicated. I'm not really sure if I'll master it. I do not want to destroy a perfectly good-looking.Zongzi. So I'll just move up here and let's witness how the miracle is done. And meanwhile, Mike saying, 祝你端午节快乐. Yes, in Chinese we would say 端午节快乐. Happy 端午 festival. We also say 端午节安康. An suggests 安全, 康, 健康. So 安全 would be safe and 健康 would be healthy. So have a healthy and safe 端午 festival. Because we mentioned earlier that during 端午 festival,Some people would consider it as the indication that summer is really deep in and all the insects and little animals are waking up, including those that are not that, you know, good to people. For example, mosquito. Mosquito is a creature. It is supposed to have the right to live in the world as well, but we don't like mosquitoes. So for Duanwu Festival,In order for you to have a healthy and safe Duanwu Festival, you also need to wear all these interesting and different lovely perfume pouch as well as other kind of, other kind of accessories. And I think for this 草边, you can stick something in. You can see here, we have some 艾叶, 艾叶, mugwort, 艾叶 in it. So stick them in. Ooh, he's much faster than I am. Jesse saying, Zigui County, Central China's Hubei province. That is true. This is where we are. We are here in Zigui County, Hubei province, mostly because this is the hometown of Qu Yuan, our patriotic poet. People commemorate him on this day because when he learned that his beloved country got invaded by other country, he decided, his other states mostly, he decided to die with his country, and the love for his country was so moving to local people that local people wanted to retrieve his body on this very long and narrow dragon boat, and that is the origin of the dragon boat race nowadays. They also wanted to throw some rice into the water so his body won't get hurt by the fishes in the river, and that is the origin of Zongzi, sticky rice dumplings nowadays. So, as you can see, Duanwu Festival has a lot to do with Qu Yuan, and we think it's the best idea to come here.To the hometown of Qu Yuan and celebrate our Duanwu Festival. 您这个现在已经有一个大概的形状了，是吗？
马上装那个艾绒的。
那我们来看一下装艾绒，好不好？
好的。
然后 ，Hello to Rakibo and Giovanni saying hello, hello to you too. And Kenny's saying, Niuniu, glad you have eaten some yesterday. Yes, I did. It was much fun and very tasty. And Ruben saying, hello, Niuniu, saw your performance in the Dragon Boat. Incredible. Thank you. Thank you. I put a lot of work in it. So thank you so much for saying it, saying you enjoyed it. And Samantha saying, may I know what the street or cultural village is called? In Chinese, we call it 非遗小巷. 非遗小巷. It's a very typical way to name something here in China, because 非 is not, 非 not, and it stands for 非物质, intangible. Intangible, so no material, it means it's intangible. 非物质, 文化, culture. 遗产 would be heritage, so intangible cultural heritage. And 非遗 suggests intangible cultural heritage. 小巷 means a lane or a valley, a lane. So this lane filled with different kinds of intangible cultural heritage items would be 非遗小巷. Ah, I think we are getting the form, the outlook of a zongzi already. Let's take a look at it. And we have Yu Lizhong saying, 屈原在日本也很有名. 屈原 is also very famous in Japan. Yes, I think in Asia, the cultures in different countries or the different civilizations would have all kinds of links towards each other. 在这个亚洲啊, 我们的文化都有千丝万缕的联系, because on the same continent, we interact, communicate with each other a lot, and that leads to this similarity, this links, this connections among different cultures. I think it's very, very interesting. And knowing that 屈原 is also famous in Japan makes me happy as well. Oh, see, he's getting it in shape. So now you can start to put some leaves on it, right? Yes, it's
already
put. Oh, it's already put? Let's look at the general shape, okay? Oh, we've got a zongzi. That is so cool. 粽子的样子. Okay, so just so you know, this is not a sticky rice dumpling. You cannot eat it. This is a 草编. This is a straw plaiting technique, allowing you to have different shape and different form of artcraft you can enjoy and have fun with. 谢谢您，我们来看一下其他，谢谢。前面这家店也是您的吗？那您能给我们看一下吗？ Okay, so right in front of it, I see 霞江微雕. Wei carries the meaning of miniature, miniaturized, small, really small and tiny. And 雕 is 雕刻. Let's learn a Chinese word, 雕刻. 我们来学习一下雕刻这个词啊。雕刻 means carving. 雕 carries the meaning of, let's say, putting on certain look on a thing, and 刻 is carve. 刻. So putting together 雕刻 would be carving. And 雕塑 is sculpture, if you still recall. 雕塑 would be sculpture. And 微雕 would be carving on really small items. So let's go inside and see what are those small items. Ah, 所以是核雕对不对? Okay, 核雕, 核桃 would be walnut. And 雕刻, carving. So actually, this is another intangible cultural heritage item that is 核雕 or 果仁. So for this one, you get to see that these items, mostly these material are this one with, 这是核桃吗?
橄榄核.
So these are walnuts or fruit stone or fruit pit, 果核, 或者是核桃. 果核 would be fruit pit, and 核桃 is the walnut. And as you can see, they are carved on these really tiny little fruit stones, and all these figures have different facial expressions. Some of them are very happy. This is a happy one, and this is an angry one. So 这个是很开心的，开心。 So this is a happy one. This is an angry one, 生气. This is a sad one, isn't it? It's a little bit sad. 不开心, 难过. Oh, serious. This is also very serious, 严肃. 严肃。And what, who else? Oh, this is a grumpy one. This is a grumpy one. I think these are very cute. Ah, and this is a little Buddha here. Little Buddha here. 您雕得好仔细，非常好看，很漂亮，而且很生动 ，very vivid。啊，这个也很。
这个是象牙果。
象牙果。
嗯，这也是植物的果实。
This is another pit of fruit, and you can hold it in your hand and play with it. I think they're very interesting.
这两个是比较小。
Ah, and also we have even smaller ones, 有更小的 these are really small. And if we...
这个五官就雕出来了，这个小佛的五官。
哦，好的，谢谢您。Ah, and he told me that you can see, actually, this little Buddha sculpture's facial expression is also very clear. Yes, very clear. He's serious. And he's... See?Tiny but vivid. 虽然很小，但是很仔细，雕得非常的仔，非常生动仔细。谢谢您。So this is 核雕 another item of the intangible cultural heritage. Very interesting. 谢谢，谢谢。Thank you very much. And we have Giovanni saying, how many of those things does he weave a day, 牛牛？ Oh, one more question. 我们有网友想问您，您一天要编草编能编多少个呀？
编不了多少个，
是吗？就太复杂了。
一个龙舟我要编两天。
一个龙舟要编两天。Okay, so for, 谢谢谢谢。For the very beautiful, very magnificent and long dragon boat, weaving or straw weaving, they need to weave, well, he needs to weave it for 2 days because it's actually very delicate and takes a long time to manufacture something that beautiful. Right here we have a, beverage stall, and I think it's really cheap, 两元美袋 2 yuan for 1 bag, that is really, really not expensive. And check them out, they're very beautiful. 它们好漂亮啊，不同的颜色 different color, 这是酒酿是吗？
用这个酒曲，然后制作的甜酒，然后再制作成
各种
不同的
酒酿。
对。
So they're in different color and different taste, very beautiful. See, being able to enjoy a beverage like this, combining with your sticky rice dumpling on Duanwu Festival is totally a treat. 所以有这样子的杯子装这样颜色的饮品，然后再加上粽子，就是我们过端午的方式了。Very nice. If you guys have any questions, let me know in the comment area. I would love to answer your questions. And we have Vivian saying, I thought before they used banana leaf to wrap the zongzi, but now I see it's different. Yes, it's another kind of leaf. And the reason we use 粽叶, 粽叶, 粽is 粽子, 叶 is leaf. So together, the leaf for 粽子, the special kind of leaf for 粽子, is because they have a special scent, fragrance. It will taste better. So yes, if you, ooh, Kenny saying, I see their extra film crew with people filming on the phone. Yes, many people are filming the making of songs and making of different art craft with their phone because this is the intangible cultural heritage lane here in the hometown of Qiyuan in Zigui County of Hubei province. And now we are standing in front of the zongzi making stall. 你好，啊，姐姐们好，啊，您在这边在编包粽子是吗？
对，
这是咱们传统的包法，是不是？
传统的包，纪念屈原的。
纪念屈原的包法。Okay, so even though we said that 粽子 the sticky rice dumplings are made in commemorating with 屈原, actually, in different places there are different fillings in it. There are sometimes meat in it, and it's salty sticky rice dumplings. But in other places, for example, here, the birthplace of Qiyuan, the sticky rice dumplings are more traditional, and in commemorating with Qiyuan, more, well, commemorating Qiyuan more, let's say, specific. I was told that if you can see the really white, beautiful, sticky rice, 糯米 in Chinese, 糯米糯米糯米 is very white, and in Chinese, white, 青白 white, 青 would be 绿绿色 green, so 青 is an ancient way to say green, so the leaves are green, and the rice are white, so 青白 Xingbai in Chinese, the pronunciation is similar to a Chinese word meaning clean and integrity. So, Xingbai is the word you use to describe the zongzi, also the characteristic of Qiyuan. And also inside, we would put one date, one Chinese date, zǎo, in it, and putting that zǎo suggests Chinese people would say, well, actually people here say 一颗红心, so one date, suggesting one pure, passionate heart, showcasing or indicating Qiyuan's love and passion to his country. So, 清白的这个粽子呢,清清白白一颗红心, that is the 粽子 you use to commemorate Qiyuan. And now I'll learn how to make the 粽子 like that. Let me go in. 我可以学一下吗?
可以。那我来跟您学一下怎么包这个粽子啊。
好嘞,那我在这里吗? 好,谢谢。 那您坐这边好不好? 我们坐一起。 Let's sit together. And 坐在一起，来拿两片，我洗一下手吗？是不是应该洗一下手？这哪里有地方洗吗？可以，没事。现在不用洗，包着这东西就不要吧。好，可以。好嘞。OK。So you need two leaves, two 粽子，我们现在要包粽子了。粽子 would be the sticky rice dumpling, and you need two 粽子 leaves. So that's the sticky rice dumpling leaf. This leaf has a special scent would make the sticky rice in it taste better. 因为这个粽叶有特殊的香味啊，所以就会更好。哎，对，两片叶，很好吃。两袖清风。两袖清风啊！Oh, there's more. So in Chinese, there's an idiom, 两袖清风, meaning incorruptible, a incorrupted official, and that is also a feature of Qiyuan. So these two leaves has that indication.
对，开始来。
这样，卷，往上卷吧。往上卷，哦，直接卷吗？直接卷，往上卷。OK，so，哦，哎，对，这样，对，往上卷，还卷，卷，再紧一点。这个也卷，这个衣服。OK， so you have to shape it in this form，
对，对，对，
like that， 好，嗯，好的。盛两勺米。盛两勺米 ，OK， two。 Spoons of rice, 两勺米, two spoons of rice.
再用筷子压实，中间压到那个尖那里去。对对。啊，OK.
And also, you have to stick it really solid, make it solid. 压实。对。压实。OK.好，再放一颗红枣。 One date, 红枣，对，是一颗红心，对不对？一颗红心。 Okay, so this one red date indicates that one pure heart of Qiyuan. Putting it in.
好，再盛一勺米。再盛一勺米。
Another spoon of rice. I didn't used to think that Chinese food or Chinese cooking can be very quantified. Because Chinese, I thought we always say 适量。
Ah,
okay. Use your finger to stick it. Really stick it in. 不要露馅儿，哎，抓住。Okay, solid. 压实。再用左手的大拇指压这个软的叶。软。啊，这还是在这一只手。还在这只手上。哎，对。Okay, so you have to make sure. It's like this.
Ah,这是一个角，一个角，这一个角，这一个角，就折下来，这个要折到这个中间。Okay,
make sure this is pointing at the middle of it.
对，再把它压实。压实了以后，压成棱角。啊，make
sure
there's很好，再往这边一折。 对，很好，这就是有棱有角，有心有肝，一生洁白，半世煎熬，这就是我们紫薇人民纪念屈原的三角粽。啊，三角粽，姐姐说的好好呀。对。Okay,
so you get to see the point here, and there would be lines, and inside we've already talked about the very white rice as well as that one date. So this is a typical. 粽子 here.
好，在这个大拇指压上线。压上线。对。Okay,
so I need to tie it up now.
来，压线，在这上面压一下。
上面压一下。
对，这个
食指把这里先勾着啊。
嗯
嗯，对，绕，从上面绕，哎，对对对，绕两转。
绕两转。
好，对，两个线重合。
好，我觉得我可以绕三转。
重回来再拉一下。
拉一下。
对，要紧一点。
要紧一点。Okay, so make it really tight. Put them together.
接成。
And tie them up.
扣。活扣。
活扣。
对。
You want to tie them up, but you also wanted to.
对，
好像有点短了。
对对，你那里多玩了一圈。
多玩了一圈。
对。
Okay, and you wanted to be easy to.
好的，好漂亮。
Untie. 真的吗？我好像没有紧。
行，
可以吗？
行了行了。
可以，
只要系上就行。
系上就行哈，好嘞。Okay, you wanted to be really tight, 很紧 ，and also it can help. Yes.这就是我的粽子 ，This is my，
它包的真好哎，
真的吗？
比我包的还好哎，
因为您帮助 ，Okay， so this is the 粽子 we have here， 粽子 sticky rice dumplings， have you tried it？ Let me know in the comment area， 谢谢您，谢谢姐姐，谢谢，这里都是啊，啊好，谢谢 ，Okay， so I'll take my things and let's move on， 谢谢，好。See, I say thank you a lot. You guys know how to say thank you now. It's 谢谢. It's very nice. All right, let's see who's with us. Oh, we have many of you joining in. Giovanni saying, I make sticky rice balls. Really? How do you make it? Let me know. And Jesse saying, 你好 to our friend Michelle or Michael. And Mark saying, I love the salted duck egg and peanut fillings for 粽子. You are...with a very special taste, I have to say. Not the same as mine, because I myself don't enjoy, salty 粽子 so much. So for me, salty 粽子, or let's say, 肉粽 or 咸粽, is not something I can enjoy, And, Mark Lee saying, 你的粽子很好了, 你的粽子很好了, your 粽子 is very nice. Thank you, that's very sweet of you. Thank you very much. And, 玉帝仲saying,well done. Thank you for praising my 粽子. Michael saying, we love sticky rice. Always get it at Yum Yum. Yes. Jesse saying, yes, I've tried 粽子 before. Quite nice. Thank you, Jesse, for replying to my message. And moving on, we can see that there are still many other things in this lane, in the intangible cultural heritage lane. And right here, we see 三驴刺绣. So, 三驴 is 3 驴. 驴 is actually talking about the 3 major clans in the Chu royal family. If you still remember, or if it is something that you can, recall, actually, 屈原 has been 三驴大夫, 三驴大夫. So, 三驴 is the 3 clans of the ancient Chu state royal family, and there are 3 lanes, or 3, let's say, major family names, and these 3 groups of people are considered the royal family in the state of Chu. And 大夫would be the leader or boss of them. So,actually, 屈原 has served the position of the headmaster of the royal school. The headmaster of the royal school would be 三驴大夫. And 刺绣 is embroidery. 刺绣 embroidery. Right here, we see 三驴刺绣. That would be the embroidery in the Chu, ancient Chu royal state or royal area. And here we see some lovely ladies showcasing刺绣，所以这里我们可以看到一些美丽的女孩子们正在做这个刺绣啊。And let's see what they are doing. 哦，慢绣是吗？慢，为什么叫慢绣啊 ？Why are we calling it 慢绣 ？Slow embroidery.
因为这个一幅画吧，一幅绣品嘛，那个应该很绣很多天。
Okay, so for one piece of art craft, they actually need to do it for over several days, 绣很多天, many days, and that is why we call it 慢工刺绣, 是吗? So as well as 三驴刺绣. 我可以试一下吗? May I have a try?
可以
啊, 谢谢。那我来试一下哦。但我怕我不，你一定要教我一下，不要让我给你绣坏。嗯。要坐下吗? Okay, I'm sitting down with this embroidery in my hand. 要跟着这个线，对不对？ Okay, as you can see, they have the drawing on it. The 线稿, we call it 线稿. So 线 would be line, and 稿 is the draft. You have it on it, and you have to fill in this petal. 这里
顺着这里下去，
直线就。啊，然后就出来，怎么出来呢？这样
出来的时候，从这个线的外缘出来，画的那个线这边外面。
嗯，
对，
这里吗？
啊。
Okay, so that's how you fill in the blanks. It's like coloring. Instead of with paints, you do it with. 这样。
对对对。
You do it with your threads, 刺绣 embroidery. Oh.是不是不够紧密？
对，比较紧。这个你再绣一针，这上去了以后，再下来，下到这个最下面这里来，它就压下去了。
哦，
这针都藏里面去了。
啊，这里啊。
对。
OK。
这个。
然后在这里。
对对，藏里面去了。这花瓣这样绣的好看些。
啊。Okay, so with this final stitch, you actually are.Hiding all of the other point or the ends of your previous stitches. So we say, 藏针脚藏针脚 In Chinese, we call it 针脚针 would be a needle. 脚 is the foot. So you're hiding the footprint. 是这样子的。那真的是很慢哎，就感觉半天才能绣。我把这个花瓣绣完好不好？我要在哪边？
在这里还加一针。
哦，这里再加一针。
对。对对，
这里
啊，再下去，
再下去。Okay, so now I get why this is called slow stitch.
对，前面扣到这个黄色的线在。
嗯 ，slow embroidery, 慢绣 ，because it really takes time. 啊，
好，这半边行了，再绣这边半边吧。
Okay, so I've finished half of the petal. 这里。
对对对
，OK。
出来后再藏一针，再绣一针长的。这把这个短的，这藏一针，这花瓣这边长宽一些嘛，这边窄一些嘛。那这个针从这个短的地方，从这个中间。
这里啊？
对，藏进去，
藏这里。I'm not doing it right.
对对对，藏下去。
I am trying to hide my.Thread needle footprint, and it's not easy. 所以您就大家姐姐们都是非遗传承人是吗？
啊，是。
都是绣娘。
对。专绣的，绣这些东西都是我们绣的。
So they are actually the cultural.
这个在下面对，挨着黄色的这里。
In cultural intangible cultural heritage inheritor that would be 传承人。这里
对
哦天哪这个布被我扎薄了吗
不是是布本来就很薄的
And as you can see the fabric is actually made of 哦
可以这先绣下去了就按花瓣的形状画的形状
啊
画的形状
他们是棉线啊、
哦、
棉线
你这针是长的
这里
对
啊、now I'm gradually getting it I cannot do this is too delicate work
这不用长了
好、哦、不用了吗可以出来啦、
啊、长多了以后就挨着黄色
挨着黄色啊、
哦、对长了
可以出来了。
嗯，对，把这短针是盖住。
嗯，是的。啊？
啊？对，就这样。
哦 ，really delicate work。哎，它为什么出来了一点？这是什么？
线打结了。这个线。
OK, this is the back of the embroidery, by the way. 这是它的背面啊，你要，然后在这里。
啊、对对，啊，这个花瓣差不多完了。
Okay, so that is my share on this. This one is mine. Okay, this one is mine. 刺绣 embroidery, 刺绣. 所以这个绣完之后是要做什么呢？
这是做那个抱枕。
是做抱枕。Okay, so these are, 啊，谢谢，谢谢您，谢谢。So this is for pillows, like this one. The final product is here for pillow, 枕头。And we can see that on the table, actually, they're also making perfume pouch. 现在我们在桌上的这些绣娘们还在做香包，香包 perfume pouch, 香包。我们来看一下这些香包。所以你们两位是在做香包是吗？这个香包是已经做好绣好了是吧？就现在把艾草放进去就可以了。So these are actually semi-made. What we are doing here is to putting in the mugwort, 艾草，放艾草进去。So these perfume pouch are all very beautiful. I think they look very nice. You can see this one, 财运. This one is to bless you with a good fortune in terms of wealth, 财运香包. And this one, I think this is for a lady because it's really pink and...delicate with all these embroidery on it, 香包，做香包。这个做的时候有什么注意事项吗？ Anything we need to pay attention to when we make it?
啊，做的时候这个梗子要把它剔出来。
啊，要剔出来。
只要这个叶片。
So you do not want the stick to be inside the perfume pouch. You only want the dried leaves. The dried leaves. 哦，我做一个吗？
叶子，
装嫩一点的。Okay, so you need to pick the nice ones without the stick. Okay, here's the stick. You take it away, 拿出来 take it away from 边边上 and then you stick other ones in it. Okay, these. Oh, 有一个狗。
嗯，对。
这个是可以的。
可以。
是的。And that's how you fill a perfume pouch. 做一个香包，香包。Thank you very much. 谢谢，非常谢谢。我们这个我是做了一半，对不对？没有完全做好。要多压一点，是不是？ You should put more. So here we've got 刺绣 embroidery and 香包 perfume pouch. Okay, 谢谢，谢谢你们。那我们接着走走，谢谢。Thank you. Like I said, in the intangible cultural heritage line, 在非遗小巷里面呢，可以看到不同的非遗的项目 different items and different things. I think they are quite interesting. Right here we see 竹编，竹编 that would be some bamboo weaving, 竹编 bamboo weaving, 竹编 they are made of bamboo sticks. And continue going, we get to see these are 艾草，艾草艾草 Alright, let's continue to move and see what are with us. In the meantime, let's see who is with us in today's live stream. Jesse saying Niuniu will do very nice embroidery. I know. Thank you for saying that. That's very sweet of you. Some artists doing some embroidery. Yes, because these embroidery actually needs or requires a lot of different, many 绣娘, many ladies.Focusing on the embroidery. So in this place, we get to see that there are over 500 people focusing their career in the intangible cultural heritage. So very impressive. And here we see 皮雕皮雕 leather carving. 皮雕 leather carving. Let's go inside and see. 你好你好哦，我们这边是皮雕是吗？ Leather carving, 皮雕。所以皮雕是可以雕出立体的来是吗？
对，可以调动立体的这种。
哇，这个好厉害！
嗯，
我来看一下这个。Okay, as you can see, this kind of leather carving actually is giving the leather a three-dimensional looking, so making it a little bit three-dimensional. 可以雕出立体的样子来。这是一只。什么鸟？
麻雀。
好，那我可以学一下吗？
对
呀，
我们来雕一个字吧。
我们来雕一个字哦，好呀。Okay, so let me carve a Chinese character. How about we carve our logo? Let's carve our logo on Learn Chinese Facebook page. Let's carve 汉，学汉语的汉。我们来雕一个汉吧。Let's carve 汉，学汉语。哦，
I think he is really fast in doing that. Actually, as for piao, the leather carving, we not only use these knives, 小刀, to carve, we can also use stamps. Maybe this is not a stamp. Do I have a stamp here? Oh yeah, stamps. To press on the leather and have some beautiful patterns on it. 哦，你现在已经在雕这个字是吗？ So we're now carving the logo of our Learn Chinese Facebook page. 我们来雕一个学汉语的汉。所以皮雕其实也是一个非物质文化遗产。This is also an intangible cultural heritage. And I, as far as I know, for leather carving, you can only use the kind of leather tanned by vegetables so that it can stay the shape and the color of it. The color or the shape can stay.Okay, so let's take a look. You can see that we need a carved knife to outline the character or outline the pattern you're thinking of.
然后再用这个工具。
哦，用工具。
把它自己把它敲出来。
把它敲出来。
它会有立体感，把这个凸显出来。
啊。In order for it to really stick out, we need to make it deeper, carve it deeper, 让它更深一点 make it deeper. So he is now making the logo of our Learn Chinese Facebook page. Yu Li Zhong saying, Chinese traditional art crafts are very colorful, aren't they? Yes, they're very colorful. We say 多种多样, 多种多样, in different shapes and different varieties. And Ball Beer saying, very beautiful. Thank you for saying that. That's very nice of you. And if you guys have any other questions or...anything you want to say, you can share with me in the comment area, share with me here on CRI Learn Chinese Facebook page, YouTube channel, as well as 英语环球广播微博 and also on my personal account, Niuniu Chinese. There are some comments here as well. We have friends saying, thank you so much for sharing such a releasing post with sincere regrets. Thank you for saying that. And we have Antonio saying, happy Dragon Boat Festival.Oh, Professor Niu Hongli. I'm not a professor, but thank you so much for sending that message. You can just call me Niu Niu. It's okay. Joshua, happy Dragon Boat Festival. Sal Lam saying nice, nice, nice indeed. Rick saying, I will certainly consider this as a distinction for my birthday next year. Destination for your birthday. That'll be very nice. I do agree with...choosing this place as a destination for your birthday because here not only there are beautiful natural resources including the three gorges, Sanxia, also there is this element of cultural and history, very impressive. And Joshua saying, if I knew Chinese, I would love to go one blue moon day. Rick also saying, and I like the pouch you made last year better. Aw, thank you very much. Dan saying, smart and have a wonderful festival, thank you. And Priyanta saying, hello, can see this live in China. Yes, you can see this live everywhere because it's on Facebook page here, I Learn Chinese. And if you want to watch it on Weibo, you can go find 英语环球广播Alright, so you guys are watching and have shared this. Thank you very much. Let me know in the comment area if you have any other questions. Let's check our domestic viewers. 让我们来看一下微博的朋友们有什么想要说的。Here, 英语环球广播 let me check. What are some comments you guys have?For our live stream, because I think it has been a really fun one. I really enjoyed this one. 太阳飞飞飞，两袖清风 That's true. two sleeves full of wind. That is a Chinese expression because in ancient times for Chinese traditional clothing, you can actually use your sleeve as a pocket. So for officials, especially local officials, if they are accepting bribes, they can have money and gold and silver filling their sleeves. But when they are not accepting bribes, when they are incorruptible officials, anything, all the things in their sleeves are just wind, 清风. So 两袖清风 suggests that there is nothing in your sleeves, there's only wind, meaning that you are an incorrupted official. 两袖清风, so it is a Chinese idiom for incorrupted, and it is used to describe 屈原 for sure, because 屈原, even though in his age, corrupted officials were basically the mainstream, but he won't budge. We say 出淤泥而不染, 出淤泥而不染. He's not contaminated by his surroundings. 蒲公英 saying, 牛牛好能干呀. Are you talking about my 粽子 as well as my 草编? 我的粽头的草编是不是都还不错? 谢谢, 谢谢蒲公英. Thank you very much. I am flattered. I'm not that handy per se, but I do want to try, and I do think doing some really, let's say, delicate handiwork is a very soothing process, very soothing. And 端午快乐for风扬风扬, and 小萝卜丁, hello to you too, very happy to see you. Thank you, and 开扬菲菲, thank you guys so much. You are watching a special live stream with the series Old Wisdom, New Insights. In this series of the show, we take you to different places in China with a historical significance. Most of them are hometowns of Chinese historical figures, and we get to show you the beauty of these places in the modern days. And today it's the Dragon Boat Festival, or Duanwu Festival. Let's call it Duanwu Festival in the future. It's more sophisticated. In Duanwu Festival, we are showcasing this 非遗小巷, intangible cultural heritage lane here in the hometown of 屈原, 屈原故里的 非遗小巷. Here we get to see a lot of intangible cultural heritage artifacts and items, and I, you know, tried my hands on some of them. I have to say it takes patience and let's say a little bit of delicate hands to figure it out, to do it. 你现在做到哪一步啦请问一下?
现在准备发现了准备缝线了缝线,
我可以缝吗?
可以缝,
oh, okay. So the carving process is almost done, and now we are trying to, actually he is, I'm only observing, he is trying to make it into accessory, something like this, something like this, a little bit like this. So you would put a ring on, and you can take it some anywhere you want. 装饰品啊, 装饰品, accessories. 哦,所以线是要穿到洞的地方,对不对? So I think we still have a little bit time to say hello to our friends on YouTube. Hey, YouTube friends, happy to have you. We have Vendama saying 你好, hello to you too. Vault saying happy Dragon Boat Festival, have a great day. Vault Punch, thank you. And also Fun Henry saying 黄酒吃咸鸭蛋, 蒸粽子煮蒜. Wow, you know a lot about Chinese traditions. Yes, for these, we have 黄酒, that is another traditional Chinese brew. 咸鸡蛋 is the salted egg, but I think it's the egg of ducks. 咸鸭蛋, excuse me, 咸鸭蛋. 粽子 is the sticky rice dumpling, and 煮蒜 is to boil some garlic. I think the boiling of garlic is also for the purpose of drive away the insects, drive away insects. You're also saying 差别应该不大, 这个, 因为我家离这个相反很近. So this, your hometown is not so far away from perhaps Hubei, so it is not very different. I think the costumes are quite similar. 不过我家通常昨天晚上就准备好了。You would prepare all the materials and items for the holiday today. Yes, I think many people here in Hubei have a lot of local wine and local snacks as well as for the festival.
Let's continue to see. He's doing a really good job because I'm handing it over to him because he's much faster than I myself. We say 穿针引线 in Chinese. 穿针引线 穿 is to stick it in, 针 is the needle, 引is to lead, and 线 is the thread. So 穿针引线 describes the needle leading the thread to go where it should be. And this is the process of 穿针引线, 穿针引线. So as you can see, for Chinese idioms, most occasions, they can mean different things. So literally, 穿针引线 would mean you use the needle to lead the thread to go to the places where they should be. But 穿针引线 can also be used figuratively to show that for some people, they would help the story to go along, help the plot to continue, or help other groups of people to understand where they should go and to link up the structure. That in Chinese is also called 穿针引线, 穿针引线的功能. So in an article, if there is a line linking all the story plots, we would also say 穿针引线. And now with this man, you get to understand why, becauseApparently, he's doing a really good job 穿针引线. Wow, that is it! You also need a lighter to, in Chinese we say 锁, 锁标是吗?这锁,这算锁?锁一下啊, to lock it in Chinese, lock.封一下封一下 to give it an end. Have a proper ending is very important, not only for live streams, but also for leather carving. 装一个环是不是? We also need a ring so that with the ring we get to carry our learned Chinese accessory everywhere we want.
都是传统的环
纯铜的。So 纯铜 would be pure bronze.
啊，哦哦，慢一点。
Okay, so if you have anything you want to say, let me know in the comment area. If you're enjoying the live stream, please like and share and comment as much as possible. It will help us a lot and help other fellow Chinese learners to find us, to watch the content, to learn Chinese culture, Chinese language, as well as the Chinese history. Okay, I think we are in the reaching the end of today's live stream with this lovely, lovely...little accessory. Let's have a final shout out to you guys. Giovanni saying, I had to purchase a couple of works and you're still here, Niuniu. I'm very happy to be here. Vivian saying, 感谢, I heard something new today's live stream at the about the Chinese culture. Very glad to know that. And Rina saying, love your outfit.Joining in late, but I will start viewing from the beginning. Thank you. Thank you very much for saying that. And ta-da, we have this. Oh, 两个吗?谢谢,谢谢您。See you at our Han accessory, 就是我们这是像钥匙链,对不 对,
对
特别感谢您,特别辛苦的。
门禁卡。
OK, 放门禁卡。OK, so in the Chinese resident area nowadays, we have this little key. They are the NFC kind of key, and you hold it near the lock will pop on, and these are the shape. So you can put them in. This is a very beautiful, interesting, I'll say, key accessory. 钥匙链, key rings, 钥匙链, 钥匙链。谢谢,谢谢您,非常感谢。送给我们了吗？
对对。谢
谢。Okay, so I've got some freebies for the live stream. 非常感谢。So if you guys ever come here, make sure you visit this place. 如果大家以后要来非遗小巷，一定要来这家这个皮雕店呢。欢迎大家来紫归。Welcome, and hopefully you can come here to Zigui County, Hubei Province. Not only during the Duanwu Festival, but also in other times as well. And that...successfully concludes the live stream of today. It has been more than 1 hour and I had a lot of fun. Hopefully you too. And thank you so very much for being with us on the very special occasion, Duanwu Festival. Tomorrow we're going to the Memorial Hall of Qu Yuan. In that place, we get to learn the entire life story of one of the most important patriotic poets here in China. Make sure you won't miss that.With your I Learn Chinese Facebook page, YouTube channel, as well as 英语环球广播微博. Thank you so very much. We'll see you next time. Bye bye, everybody. Bye.